Hey everyone, welcome back to my corner of the internet. I hope you are all doing well. Today I am going to show you what is in my carry-on bag for when Nick and I go on our honeymoon. Jumping right in, the bag that I am actually using as my carry-on is this grey backpack from AS Colour here in New Zealand. This backpack is one that I use for work quite a lot because it has this really cool like padded section in the back for laptops where you don't even need to put your laptop in a case. You can just like chuck it straight in the bag and it will still be all protected. So I thought, even though I'm not taking my laptop away with me, this would be a pretty good bag to take all of the bits and pieces that I need on the plane. So first off, I'm going to show you everything that is in this front little pocket here, and this is basically just loose little bits and pieces that I knew that I would want quick access to. So the first thing is my Kindle. This will definitely come in handy when we are waiting around in airports, when we're on the plane and things like that. This basically comes everywhere with me, which is why, if you can kind of see, the case is so like ratty and it's like missing bits and pieces, because I've had this case probably for like 4 years now, and yeah, it's had a lot of wear and tear. The next thing in here is a little eye mask for if I want to sleep on the plane. Then I have my Canon G7X, which is my vlogging camera. I do plan on creating videos for all the different places that we go on our honeymoon, but as I said before, I'm not going to take my laptop away with me because I don't want to have to worry about editing anything while I go away. So those videos will be coming most likely sometime in May, so keep your eyes peeled for them. And here I also have a little bag filled with a bunch of different technology things. So I have a portable power bank so I can charge like any devices and stuff on the go. This thing here, if you can see that, is actually a camera lens. So this pops out and you can put it like that, and then you can clip it onto your phone. And this is a wide angle lens, so if I'm wanting to take any photos but my phone camera isn't big enough, then I can also put this on. And then in here as well, I have a bunch of different SD cards because, again, as I said, I'm not going to be taking my laptop away with me, so I didn't want to run out of room on any of my memory cards. I have this little dongle that I need because my stupid iPhone won't connect to like most headphone jacks because it doesn't have a headphone jack anymore. And then I also have a joining plug which allows two sets of headphones to be plugged into like the same device, because Nick and I are also taking his iPad because it's bigger than my iPad, so that, again, if we're bored at the airport, we can be like watching any movies or TV shows. As sort of a side note, I don't have them in my carry-on luggage right now because I don't think I'm going to need them on the first leg of our journey, which is from New Zealand to Los Angeles. But Nick and I are also taking a pack of cards, and then also we bought a pack of Uno that we can, I don't know, like play in the evenings if we want, or play at the airports, just to kind of keep ourselves entertained. So I felt a bit like I was trying to buy this to entertain a child when I bought it at the store, but I also haven't played Uno for a while, so it might be fun. The last thing in the front pocket of my bag is this little coin purse from Kiki K. I can't remember if I bought this for myself or if someone bought this for me, but this is what I'm going to use as my wallet when we go away, because I have quite a big wallet normally, but I also don't need to take every single thing that's inside it. So this is easy. I can store like coins and cards and any like cash and stuff in here as well. If you can see up here on the bag, there is also this tiny little pocket up here, which at the moment just has a cord for Nick's iPod, because his iPod still has one of those like old school Apple charging points. But closer to the time, I will also put in my headphones into there, and then also my phone charger as well, so that, again, it's kind of like easily accessible if I need it, but it's not gonna like tangle around with everything else in the front pocket of my bag. Moving on to the big pocket of my bag, the first thing is, as I said, Nick's iPad. So this is it. I feel like it's like first generation, I don't know, but anyway, it's got like a big enough screen that we can be watching stuff at the airport and we don't have to be like on our phones chewing through data or wasting the battery. The next thing I have is my travel wallet. This trusty thing I have had for so long now. I feel like I bought it in like 2013, and the fact that it's this green color, even though it's a little bit dirty now, it definitely makes it super easy to see in your bag because it's such a bright color. In here we have our passports, we have some Oyster cards, we have some cash, we have a international driver's license for Nick because we are going to be driving, well, Nick is going to be driving while we're in Canada and he needed that. And then I also have some pens so that when we are needing to fill out forms, we don't need to like wait until we get into the airport terminal, we can be doing them on the plane and places like that. I also have a pair of cozy pink socks in my travel bag. These are always a staple for when I am traveling long haul. These ones are like woolen socks because we are going to Iceland and we're going to Banff where it's going to be super cold. But when I get on the plane, I like to take my shoes off, but I don't just like to have my like little trainer socks on. I like to be nice and cozy, so I always put a pair of like big fuzzy socks over whatever socks I'm wearing at the time, and then I like feel a little bit better about not having shoes on the plane. Next up, I have my Ziploc bag for my liquids that I'm allowed to take on the plane, but I really don't have very many of them. I've got some face moisturizer that I've decanted into a smaller container. I have some double base gel, which is essentially just like a really strong moisturizer, and if you have dry skin or eczema, this is really good. So as you guys know, I've talked about it before, but I do actually have eczema and dry skin, and I'm a little bit worried that the aircon or just being on a plane might make it a little bit worse. So I've got some of this. And then the last thing I have is this Glossier Coconut Balm.com that my sister got me for Christmas. I use this as like a chapstick, a lipstick, but then I also sometimes put it on my eczema because it is quite moisturizing, so it like feels nice on my skin. And this is definitely something that I think when we go to America, I will be buying another one of, because I haven't had this for very long and I've almost used it all up because I really love it. This is also the drink bottle that I'll be taking with me on my honeymoon. It's pretty handy because it has like a little handle, so it's easy to carry around, which is good because it's also one of those glass drink bottles and it's got like a rubber casing on it, which I think helps keep the water cold, but it also helps like if you drop it, it doesn't completely smash. But yeah, this is kind of like the perfect size for traveling, so that is also in my carry-on bag. I do also plan on having a pair of jeans in my carry-on bag because Nick and I live in Wellington, so we have to catch a domestic flight from Wellington to Auckland before we then get on our international flight from Auckland to LA. And on the flight to LA, I plan on being in like full cozy gears, like hoodie and leggings, and just being super cozy. But I feel a little bit weird about doing that on the domestic flight, so I think I'll probably like wear a pair of jeans to Auckland, and then when we get to the international terminal, I will like change into my leggings. The last thing that I have to show you, I feel like some people are probably gonna laugh at me or call me like a travel nerd or whatever, but it is essentially a folder of like our whole entire trip. Some of the activities and things that we are doing require you to have like a printout ticket, so I needed to print out some stuff, but I do also like to have like physical copies of shuttles that we've booked, or physical copies of like hotel reservations, of flight reservations, just so if for whatever reason we ever have any trouble, instead of having to like search for them on our phone, or if for whatever reason we don't have any like battery on our phone, we do have everything we need right here. I've also got a copy of our travel insurance, and then also a photocopy of both Nick's and my passports. So again, if anything happens to our passports, we've got like a physical copy, and then we also have a photo on our phones of like our passport details as well. So who knows, it's probably going overboard in terms of like having everything organized, but I did one of these like folders of all the pieces of paper when we went to Italy and New York a couple years ago before we moved back from London, and it was just super handy to have everything in one folder. You don't have to worry about like trying to find an internet cafe. And yeah, I don't know why I'm trying to justify it, because I know this works for me, so it doesn't really matter if you think it's silly or it doesn't work for you. But yeah, that is the final thing in my carry-on bag. So that's it. Let me know down in the comments if what I've packed in my carry-on bag is similar to what you normally pack in your carry-on bag. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I will see you all later on. And don't forget to keep an eye out for those travel videos coming soon.